We have people over here. That's Natalie and Chris, and thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you for having us.
You're from the student run a newspaper called Torch on Boston College, and thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you.
Maybe if you could start off, Chris, with telling us how this whole thing started, how the Torch started.
Sure. So it was early on in the second semester of my junior year, January or February of 2013, that the idea to engage students in the new evangelization through means of a newspaper came to me. And the first thing I needed was other students who also believed in that mission. So I went to my friend Ethan Mack, who's now one of our executive editors and features columnists, and he loved the idea. I also was just getting to know Natalie at the time. She was a freshman back then. And we were working together with another student organization. And I brought her on board, and then also brought in my friend Stephanie, who I had met in another class. She was in the business school, but was taking a theology course. So we brought her on as our business manager, and because we were trying to figure out what the financial situation would look like in terms of actually running a paper. Having that solid core together, we went to faculty in various departments to gauge interest among faculty, build support, and then went to campus ministry as well. And Father Tony Penna, who's the head of campus ministry, has been very gracious, and things took off from there.
Great. Now, Natalie, on a campus that has many publications, a Catholic campus, why was it so important to establish this particular publication, The Torch?
Well, we do have a lot of material going around campus, which is great, and all of it's wonderful. But Chris and I noticed through talking with faculty and other students that there really was this void on campus where there was not a lot of talk about Catholic issues or what, you know, students were thinking about their faith on campus. And as a Catholic university, I think it's very important that we have people talking about what's going on and what they're thinking, what their faith life is like.
Talk about your schedules too. I know it's a busy being a college student, but to run a newspaper as well, what's that like, keeping it all together?
It's definitely difficult, especially as a double major. I feel like my time is always being stretched thin. But when something's important to you, you make time for it. And it really is important, I think, to spread the mission and to make sure that people are talking about it. And at the end of the day, when you see it in print and online, it's a good feeling, and you know that it's worth it.
Now, Chris, you know, we go way back to your days at St. Raphael School when you were about to graduate and move on to Arlington Catholic. And you reminded me before the show that you gave me the tour of the school.
Yes.
And then what did I do? I showed you something.
You showed me the iPod video was new at the time, and you had one, and you showed me some Catholic TV programming from your iPod.
Did I act like I thought it was really cool?
Yes.
Were you impressed or not?
I was impressed.
Oh, that's good. Well, I'm impressed with the fact that you're a grad student, but yet you remain connected and involved with the paper. What motivates that?
So I graduated with a double major in classics and theology back in the spring from BC. I'm back now pursuing my master's in theology. The reason that I stay involved is our staff, we just have a really great group of students, very faith-filled Catholics and Christians of other denominations working on this. And it's a mission that I really believe in, and I think that to be at BC and to not be a part of it was something I just couldn't envision, even now moving into grad school. As busy as that gets, this is very important.
Talk about the running of the paper, too, and how you guys all collaborate together, and what's it like, you know, making deadlines and all that stuff? How does that all work?
Sure, we're in a bit of a transition right now. Since I graduated, I handed over my role as editor-in-chief to Natalie. So she's taken the reins, and you know, it's been a learning process. She's doing a wonderful job, eminently competent and capable.
Thank you. Yeah, we publish once a month, so okay. It's manageable, and we have editors and our wonderful writers, so.
We know what it's like to publish once a month. We have the Catholic TV Monthly and be up against that deadline. Now, I'm kind of a back-end guy in terms of the, you know, the actual printing of the publication and all the financial arrangements that go along with that. Mm-hmm. Can you just give us a little insight? How does that work? Do you do it right on campus?
We actually go through TCI Press, and that's how we print.
They're located in Seekonk, Mass.
Ah, I see.
And they'll come and deliver the papers on the morning delivery at our office, and then we run around campus getting it all over the place.
Okay. Well, talk about the collaboration between Natalie, you and the editors and the writers as well. And what are some of the stories that you're trying to look for or you talk about?
Well, we have our meetings where we come together and we ask, you know, is there anything interesting that's happening on campus? And a lot of what we focus on is campus news. So, like, things that are going on that involve faith or other student groups that are doing something we think is really interesting or faith-filled. And then also we look for reflections from students, and we have a section called Catholicism 101, which kind of highlights different aspects of the Catholic faith. And something really I think that's interesting that we do is faith in action. So we find a volunteer group on campus or something like in that nature, and we highlight what they're doing, and I think that's really great.
Yeah. And this is testimony to the fact that newspapers are not dead, you know, that newspapers are still very, very effective way of transmitting information and inspiring people. But does The Torch have an online presence at all?
Definitely. Our website is thetorchbc.com, and so our latest issue just came out this Wednesday, and all the new material is up on the website. We also have a Facebook page. You can search for us, The Torch, and Twitter and Instagram, and for both of them, the handle is @thetorch_BC.
Well, we get it all going on.
Yeah. Well, we wish you all the best
in
the future. Yeah. And, you know, it sounds like the torch is starting to set a fire on campus. Thanks so much, Natalie and Chris,
so
for being with us.
Thank you.